Okay, so we were discussing text number 3.13 yesterday, today 3.14, Bhagavad Gita, and cycle of sacrifice. Okay, so sacrifice brings rains and then the crops, grains, like that, living entities gets prosperous and happy. So that section is 3.14, okay. Okay. अन्नाद् भवन्ति भूतानि पर्जन्याद् अन्य संभवा यज्ञाद् भवति पर्जन्यो यज्ञ कर्म समुद्भवा. All living bodies subsist on food grains, which are produced from rains. Rains are produced by performance of yajna, and yajna is born of prescribed duties. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Srila Baldev Vidyabhushan, a great commentator on the Bhagavad Gita, writes as follows. Ye indradi angatya vasthitam yagyam sarveshwaram vishnum abhirachya tachesham ashnati ashnanti ten tad deha yatram sampadyanti te santaha sarveshwarasya yagya purushasya bhaktaha सर्व किल विषयर अनादि काल विवृद्धैर आत्मानुभव प्रतिबंध कैर निखिलै पापैर विमुच्यन्ते. द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड हु इज नोन एज द यज्ञ पुरुष और द पर्सनल बेनिफिशियरी ऑफ ऑल सैक्रिफाइसेस इज द मास्टर ऑफ ऑल द डेमिगॉड्स हु सर्व हिम एज द डिफरेंट लिम्स ऑफ द बॉडी सर्व द होल. The demigods like Indra, Chandra and Varuna are appointed officers who manage material affairs, and the Vedas direct sacrifices to satisfy these demigods so that they may be pleased to supply air, light and water sufficiently to produce food grains. So all the demigods are like... the analogy is given like the all the limbs of the body serves the whole. Similarly, all the demigods serves the Supreme Lord. Okay, so when the Supreme Lords are worshipped, all the demigods are automatically worshipped. So the way when the food is given to the stomach, all the limbs are automatically served the food. Okay, so Vedas direct sacrifices to satisfy these demigods so that they may be pleased to supply. So air, light, water, Indra, Chandra, Varuna, they provide these things. So Vedas says that you worship them and you will get all these things properly, rains and water and everything. So you will get proper food, grains and everything. Now, when Lord Krishna is worshipped, the demigods who are different limbs of the Lord are also automatically worshipped. Therefore, there is no separate need to worship the demigods. For this reason, the devotees of the Lord who are in Krishna consciousness offer food to Krishna and then eat. A process which nourishes the body spiritually. So this process of offering food to Krishna and then accepting, honoring the remnants of Krishna, Mahaprasad, this is not just a material process, this is a spiritual process. It will not only nourish the body materially, but also spiritually. Okay, that will give us the spiritual intelligence. It will purify us, because material food only will give us healthy body, maybe. Or nourish, it will nourish us materially, but the prasad will give us spiritual nourishment also. So that means our, if a person takes only prasad, for him it will be very easy to understand bhakti, understand the concepts of Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. It will be very easy to chant Hare Krishna, right? When you eat outside, you can understand the change in the consciousness. A person who is strictly following the diet That means strictly taking only Krishna Prasad, and if he happens to eat sometime outside or something non-prasad, he can easily understand the difference in the consciousness. Okay, so this prasad of Krishna nourishes the body spiritually also. By such action, not only are past sinful reactions in the body vanquished, but the body becomes immunized to all contamination of material nature. Past karmas are vanquished, and also body becomes immunized to all contamination of material nature. The spiritually immunity will increase. Okay, that is, when you eat normal food, healthy food, you become immune to the virus and other problems. But when you take Krishna Prasad, you become immune to material contamination. This Maya will not affect you. So when there is an epidemic disease, like now we have COVID-19. So when there is an epidemic disease, an antiseptic vaccine protects the person from the attack of such an epidemic, right? Similarly, food offered to Lord Vishnu and then taken by us makes us sufficiently resistant to material affection. Wow. And one who is accustomed to this practice is called a devotee of the Lord. So this prasad will make us immune to Maya. Okay. Prabhupada is saying that the food offered to Krishna is like a vaccine that will, and then taken, when we take this prasadam, we will become sufficiently resistant to material affection. We will not get attracted towards Maya if we take only Krishna prasad. Therefore, a person in Krishna consciousness who eats only food offered to Krishna can counteract all reactions of past material infections, which are impediments to the progress of self-realization. So we have to be very careful in our eating habits, what we eat. Okay, and Prabhupada is saying that who takes only Krishna Prasad, he is called a devotee of the Krishna, devotee of the Lord. Okay. So a person who is in Krishna consciousness eats only food offered to Krishna, and then he can counteract all reactions of past material infections. Past material infection means he might be engaged in some material activity, some sense gratification in past. So that infection, that things he can easily overcome. Because if he is not able to overcome, then those things will come back sometime and they will create some problem, that like impediments, and they will be like stumbling blocks in self-realization process. So Krishna Prasad will help us to overcome those things. On the other hand, one who does not do so, that means one who does not take Krishna Prasad. So one who does not do so continues to increase the volume of sinful action. His sinful action will increase, and this prepares the next body to resemble hawks and dogs, to suffer the resultant reactions of all sins. The material world is full of contaminations, and one who is immunized by accepting prasadam of the Lord, food offered to Vishnu, is saved from the attack, whereas one who does not do so becomes subjected to contamination. Okay, so material world is full of material contamination. Everywhere Maya, Maya, Maya. So person who is taking Krishna Prasad, he will be having a coverings. Okay. He will be immunized from this material infection. Okay. He will not be attacked. Or Prabhupada is saying he will be saved from the attack of Maya. And one who does not take Prasad and take outside food, he will become subjected to material contamination. Very strictly we have to follow that means, right? It is direct medicine, it seems. Okay, vaccine. Okay, anti-Maya vaccine. Right? So we have to be very careful now. So food grains or vegetables are factually eatables. The human being eats different kinds of food grains, vegetables, fruits, etc. and the animals eat the refuse of the food, grains and vegetable, grass, plants, etc. Human beings who are accustomed to eating meat and flesh must also depend on the production of vegetation in order to eat the animals, because animals will eat grains. Therefore, ultimately, we have to depend on the production of the field and not on the production of big factories. Very important point. Prabhupada was very against of these big factories. Okay, that even though if you want to eat meat, you need animal to eat, and then animal will eat grain. So you need field to cultivate, not the factories. So this factory culture is completely against of Vedic culture. Okay. So the field production is due to sufficient rain from the sky, and such rains are controlled by demigods like Indra, Sun, Moon, etc. And they are all servants of the Lord. So the Lord can be satisfied by sacrifices. Therefore, one who cannot perform them will find himself in scarcity. That is the law of the nature. So Prabhupada is saying, in any way you have to surrender to Krishna. In any way. Even though you take non-veg, you have to get fruit. Animal has to get fruit. Grains, and grains has to come from rain, and rain has to come from Indra. Indra get power from Krishna. So ultimately it is Krishna who is sitting in the top. So any way you go, but you have to surrender to Krishna. And if not, you will be having so much scarcity. That's the law of nature. So yajna, specifically the Sankirtan yajna prescribed for this age, must therefore be performed to save us at least from the scarcity of food supply. So Prabhupada is saying that specifically yajna, specifically the Sankirtan yajna prescribed for this age, must therefore be performed to save us at least from scarcity of food supply. So wherever there is a point like yajna, Prabhupada brings and clears the doubt. What doubt? That what to do, what kind of yajna I should do. In Kali Yuga, no other confusion. Only one yajna, Sankirtan yajna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Only one yajna. Okay, so Sankirtan Kali Yuga. In Kali Yuga, what is the yajna? Sankirtan yajna. So even if somebody performs properly Sankirtan yajna, he will not have any scarcity of food. He will get food. Okay. So, now there is a conversation of Srila Prabhupada with one of the disciples, Guru Kesha. He asked that Russia is importing its food grains now. So why can, Prabhupada is saying that, why can they not produce sufficient? Russia is such a big country, they should be able to produce sufficient food grains. He says that, and Eastern Europe, which is also communist, gets all its supplies from other place, right? Communist government. So, Prabhupada is saying that Russia is very big country, so much land is there, then why cannot they produce food grains? So, another disciple says that there is no rain. So then you have to depend on rain. And when we say parjanyad anna sambhava yagyad bhavanti parjanya, that means because Russia is a very big place, but they are not able to produce grain. So why? Because there is no rain. And for rain you have to depend on Indra or demigods or Krishna at least. You know? So Prabhupada is saying that means you take one side, Ardha Kukuti, that is called Ardha Kukuti Nyaya. Cut the chicken in half and separate the mouth. It is expensive, and keep the rear side. You will get eggs. So this is Ardha Kukuti Nyaya. The rascal does not know that if you separate the mouth, there will be no egg. So there was this famous story that a person was having this hen which was giving golden egg. So this fellow has to feed the hen something, right? So that... So he thought that this face, the mouth part of hen is no use. Why? It is only eating. The back side is good because it is giving golden egg. So remove this. So he cut the head of the chicken or the hen. So what happened? There was no more golden egg. Okay. So that's why Prabhupada is saying that these people are they just want that food grains should come from somewhere. But what is the other side? Other side is that you have to worship Krishna, then only the rain will be proper and then grain will come. So if nobody is worshipping Krishna and not doing any yajna, then how the rain will come? Then how, if rain is not there, then how you will get the food grains? So they are telling, no, yajna means you have to give something, na? So that we don't want. So remove that. We don't want to do any yajna. We just want food grains. That means golden egg. So that's what Prabhupada is saying. This is called Ardha Kukuti Nyaya. This is not good. So these people are foolish. They don't understand the whole process. They understand only half process. That what is golden egg? Na? Food grains we want, that's it. They don't know from where it is coming. So that's why they, nobody recommends that you should do yajna. Okay. So Prabhupada is saying that we live on food grains. We cannot live on meat eating. It is not possible. However great a meat eater he may be, he must have some grains and some vegetables. Okay. Prabhupada is saying very practically that vegetable and grains are required. Only by eating meat one cannot live. Some grains, some vegetable he has to eat. That is his life. Yes, therefore grains, vegetables are actually our food. Now I am living and getting energy by eating grains and vegetables. How should my energy be utilized? It should be utilized for the purpose from where I am getting energy. I am getting energy from the Supreme Lord by supplying of this food stuff. Therefore, my energy should be utilized for the service of the Supreme Lord. So, Prabhupada is saying wonderful idea that I am eating and getting energy. So, what is the use of my energy? My energy use is that I should serve the one from whom I am getting energy. So, food grains I am getting energy and food grains I am getting from Krishna. So, I should, after taking food grains, when I become energetic, I should serve Krishna with that energy. That's what Prabhupada is saying. Okay. So, that is a very wonderful verse, and people have to understand that how the process is there, okay? So, okay, 1 second. Okay. So this 14th shloka, it talks about the sacrifice brings rains which nourishes the crop or food grains, and food grains, using food grains, living beings becomes happy and prosperous. So why there is no need to worship demigods? So first section of the purport says that there is no need to worship demigods. Why? Because demigods are only the appointed officers for material management. Vedas are giving this sacrifices process to satisfy these demigods to achieve all material supplies. But what happens? If you satisfy Krishna, then all the demigods are automatically satisfied and you will get all the supplies. So there is no separate need to worship the demigod. So actually if you need food, grains and all, you have to worship demigods. That's the point here. But if you worship Krishna, then there is no need to worship them because they are ultimately satisfied because you are worshipping now their head, Supreme Lord. Okay? So, that's the point. So, and then another second point in the purport was very wonderful that prasadam gives immunity from all material reactions. So, that means antiseptic vaccine that is during some epidemic. So that example Prabhupada gave. So this prasadam, Krishna prasadam, which is the food which is offered to Krishna first, that Krishna prasadam is like anti-vaccine from Maya. Okay. So that means this bhakti process, Krishna conscious process, is like that you take prasadam, you take only food which is offered to Krishna, that means prasadam. And that way you will get freedom from all past sins, and in future you will be immunized from further material affections. So if somebody is not, third section of the purport is that if you are not accepting Krishna prasad, that means you are not offering food to Krishna, then those persons continues to increase the volume of sinful reaction. That means they will keep doing sinful activities. So that's why when somebody starts taking prasadam, they will stop sinful actions. Okay, so because their chetana, their consciousness will change. And if you are, that's why if somebody is getting some sinful thoughts, some lusty thoughts, that means you have to check whether he is, what kind of food he is eating. If he is not eating pure food, he will get all these things. So thus, in this way, that person will suffer and he will do more and more sinful activity, and his next body, some animal body, will be ready for him. Because when you do sinful activity, you are creating an animal body for you. So then, Sankirtanajna, how it is important that even for supply of food and protection from scarcity, yajna has to be done. And what kind of yajna in Kali Yuga prescribed? Sankirtanajna. So for all eatables, we have to depend upon the production of fields, which depends on rains, and rains are controlled by demigods who are servants of Krishna, and then Krishna can be satisfied only by yajna. And for Kali Yuga, the yajna is Sankirtan yajna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Sankirtan yajna. Sankirtan means many people come together and chant the holy name of Krishna loudly. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Thank you so much. Shri Prabhupada ki jai. 15th shloka we shall do tomorrow. Hare Krishna. If you have any question, you can ask related to today's verse. Any question is there, you can ask. Hare Krishna. Okay. So if there is no question, we can disconnect. Okay, you have, okay, please ask. You can speak, I think, if you have, okay.
Hare Krishna,
Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
So I have a picture of Goddess Durga on my altar. So every day when I do the Mangal Aarti or Gaura Aarti, I worship Krishna, but I forget to do Aarti for her sometimes. But sometimes it comes in my mind that I should do it, but I don't. I get confused at that time. What should I do? So can you please guide? What should I do with the picture of the Goddess Durga?
Okay, so there is no confusion, no problem. If you have already having picture or photo of Mother Durga since before you were in ISKCON, so there is no problem, you can still have, but you can worship Durga with a right understanding that she is the energy of Krishna, she is the external potency, and you can pray to Durga that she should give you the strength so that you can serve Krishna nicely. Mother Durga serves Krishna very nicely. Prabhupada says that she is doing the tireless, thankless job. You know, I mean, she's just day and night, she's working to please Krishna, to do service to Krishna. And day and night, Mother Durga is working to please Krishna, in the service of Krishna. Tirelessly she is working. So you can ask that she should bless and so that you can serve Krishna nicely. And then aarti time, what you can do is like the way we show aarti to our guru parampara, like that you can just, after completing aarti, you can show to Durga also, no problem. And then you can show to guru parampara and all, because she is also Vaishnavi, devotee of Krishna, so you can just show aarti to her also after offering it to Krishna. And our consciousness is right based on our shastras and our guru parampara, that they are all demigods. They are also devotee of Krishna, and 100% they are great devotee than us. Okay, so we can still pay obeisances and pranam and offer aarti to them. So there is no issue. Okay, does that answer your question?
Yes, Prabhuji. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna. Any other question? Okay, thank you so much for joining. Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki jai.